Then the Chamber of Petroleum Consumers Ghana has called on government to consider supporting the bulk oil storage and transportation company BOST to open a good credit line or system in order to stock oil for the country's strategic reserves or stocking needs. This follows the collapse of the price for WTI crude oil, selling at negative $1.58 a barrel the last time we checked. Let's get some more understanding on what is happening with crude oil prices. Joining me is an analyst with the Institute for Energy Security, Raymond Nwokwo. Thanks for joining us this afternoon, Raymond. Good to see you. Now, let's differentiate between what WTI is and how different it is from Brent crude.
Thank you very much. In the crude markets, we have benchmarks. And for here in Ghana, we concern ourselves with the international benchmark, that's Brent crude, mostly in the European market. And in the US, that's America, they also have their international benchmark, that's the WTI. So that's the difference.
Okay.
So most of the times, what's happening in the American market does not directly affect us, but it all in the oil industry, so indirectly have some repercussion for us here.
All right, we'll come to the repercussions, but what is triggering this drop to the negatives? What does it mean for oil prices and for production globally?
Okay, for what happened yesterday is basically due to storage space completely or literally getting overwhelmed. Oil products are traded in its future prices, and May futures were supposed to expire yesterday, today. And because yesterday was the last day to today's ending, a lot of holders want to sell off their futures and enter the June futures. So therefore, they are looking for buyers, and there are no buyers because there's no storage space for you to buy and hold. So therefore, they better have to pay. Producers have to pay buyers to be able to take their products off their hand. So basically, that's what happened. We are in negative because producers have to pay the buyers to take off their products. So that's what happened yesterday.
Okay.
And even to today. Yeah.
So you've written a piece about this. I was reading about it, and you make the point. We are making the point that this has no trickle down effect whatsoever on prices at the pumps here locally. But you also talk about repercussions. Can you put all of that into perspective for us?
Yeah, I said it's not having direct effect on our local pumps here because we do not trade in WTI, we trade in international Brent crude. However, this morning around 11 o'clock, we realized that the Brent crude had a very big hit. It's now below 20. That's the lowest since 2002, sorry, that's 18 years ago. So we should know that what happened in America yesterday is also having an effect in the European market, which Ghana is also a stakeholder. So like I said yesterday in my piece in the evening, I said prices will not significantly be affected. But what happened today at 11 a.m., when it continues, because prices are still coming down below 20, we may see a significant reduction going to the first pricing window of May. Yeah.
Right.
And what it means for government also is that even the small revenue they want to get from a broken oil industry is also going to dry up. Because remember, I always say that, remember, we peg our oil projections around $62 per barrel. That's the beginning of the year. And now prices are below 20. That's a very huge crumbling of prices at them. At the world oil market.
Great. I want to ask you, because we've been reporting this, COPEC asking that BOST stocks up its oil reserves. I don't know whether that is the key learning from what the US is experiencing, but what do you make of the call?
Okay, so IES have advocated for this since February, the beginning of February, when we monitor the market in January through to February. I spoke to your friend Emmanuel Wiafe, telling me how if BOST was supposed to be managed properly and have a lot of strategic capacity, we should be buying a lot of the product now and storing, because other countries are doing it. Recently, America did it. They bought the product around $30 per dollar, and even China, when they were under the pandemic, still they were buying strategic reserves because it is going to help them in the future when prices began to rally. You understand? So it's a good call. It's not late. Prices are still tumbling. Mm. And because demand is supposed to crash in the month of April by 29 barrel. So definitely it's good for us to buy. If we don't have the capacity, we can get the capacity for from the private sector, come into negotiation with them to get this capacity so that in the future our consumers can have some relief when prices begin to rally up.
Just hold on a moment for me. I want to ask you one last question to do it. Tallow Oil PLC, which has appointed Rahul Deer as Chief Executive Officer and Executive Director of the group. Now, Rahul, according to a statement released by Tallow, will take up his appointment from the 1st of July 2020, and Dorothy Thompson, currently Executive Chair of Tallow, will return to her position as non-executive chair after a limited period of handover. That is Rahul you are seeing in your shots. The statement says he brings extensive leadership experience in oil and gas to Tallow. He is currently CEO of Delonex Energy, an Africa-focused oil and gas company that he founded in 2013. We have just 30 seconds for this. We know that Tallow has been struggling in recent months. Raymond, what should be the focus of this new CEO?
Okay, first, it has to be about cost management. Second, it has to be about extensive research to determine where they should continue investing their capital resources inside. Because at the moment, if you don't cost manage, you're going to run into bankruptcy. So it's first time you do a lot of cost analysis to evaluate all their production stock, which one to close and which one to aggressively pursue. This is cost management, cost analysis, and a lot of research to know which one to pursue and which one to reject.
All right. Thank you so much for your perspective this afternoon. That was